scripture out of the book of Revelation, chapter 22. He showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding from the throne of God and of the Lamb. In the middle of its street and on either side of the river was the tree of life, which bore 12 fruits, each tree yielding fruit every month. The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. There shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and the Lamb shall be in it. This is a beautiful vision that the Apostle John was seeing, and the Holy Spirit showed him the picture of the throne of God. I want to use the ocean today as a picture of the throne of God. Now, we understand the Bible brings a tremendous revelation of God being love. God is love. As you look at this ocean, picture this as God's throne. It's huge. And that the throne, proceeding out of the throne, is rivers of His pure love. Look at the beauty of this ocean. You can't even see all the way across it. It is so deep, it's immeasurable. The throne of God is huge. Folks, don't ever think the throne of God is just a person sitting on a seat. It encompasses who God is. And the beauty of the throne, as John saw it, was out of the throne began to come a river. Now think for a moment, Jesus, when he was on earth and before his death, he said, out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. You see, the throne is really inside you also. The throne is the kingdom of God, his rulership, and who he is. Now out of that throne is coming rivers. That river is what carries you through life. His love is carrying me, and it's coming from within me out. Now in that river, you're in it, and the river takes all kinds of shapes at times. The river can be very smooth, and you know, like there's rivers in Arizona, Colorado River. You float on that river, and at times it can be very smooth and pleasant, and then all of a sudden the river takes a bend, and you don't really know where you're headed. You're just being carried by this river. The river can have rapids. It can be very choppy at times. It can be life-threatening. Rivers can be magnificent, I mean powerful things, and people have died in rivers. But I want you to know that God's love is carrying you through life. Life can have a lot of problems in it. Jesus even said that in this world you will have tribulation. It's not the tribulation, it's not the problems that carry you, but it is that river. Now, Bible instructs us to stay in the love of God. Now, this is a battle, this is a fight. You have to stay in His love and allow His love to carry you. It will carry you, and at times in life, you really don't know where you're headed. Just like in a river, you see a bend, and you don't really know where that bend is going to take you, but you stay in the river. And pretty soon that bend will curve, and then you may hit real smooth places. In life, it just seems like, oh man, it's just so magnificent, and you know, smooth sailing, as they say, no problems. And then pretty soon there's a couple ripples, and then all of a sudden there's just this shaking rapids. And a lot of times we freak out. We don't know what's going on. Stay in His love. There's several things as I begin to think about this that I'd like to bring to your attention. One of the things is there can be rocks in a river. And I want you to think of rock as being offenses. In the river, you're floating along, and all of a sudden you hit an offense. You hit a rock. Now that rock can do you damage, but you have to allow the love of God to increase. The way God overcomes offenses is he increases the level of the water, which is that he wants to love you. So when you're offended in life, and the Lord said offenses will come. So when you're offended in life, the idea many times is to try to retaliate to the rock. Try to hit the rock back. Try to hit the person back. Get vengeance. Get a judgmental spirit. And you're trying to fight the offense by attacking the offense. And this is not what you're to do. Jesus talked about forgiveness. Forgiveness causes you to look away from the offender and look to God. Look to the ocean. Do you think the ocean is running out of water to feed and increase your river? That God's love, when I'm offended and I go to God and I say, Lord, I let go of that person, I forgive that person, and I love you. I just love you, Lord. All of a sudden, his love increases. The water level gets higher, and the rock no longer are you hung up on it or been offended by it. God pours his love into your heart abundantly. That will match any kind of offense. I know there's little ones to devastating ones. Even the worst offense or betrayal that comes into your life, turning to God, his love will rise into your heart and raise the level of the water, and you'll continue down that river. Another thing that happens in a river is you get snagged. You float along, you know, you're just doing great, and all of a sudden something snags you. You know, a branch or a weed or something grabs you, and you're snagged. Now the water keeps going by, but you're stuck. I believe what snags are in our Christian journey are events and situations. They can even be good. I think of my history. I've been following Jesus for over 40 years, and I can look back, say, 25 years ago, I was involved in an outpouring revival in a fellowship, and people were getting saved, and just marvelous things. Church services. You'd go to church. I'd go to church Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, weekends. I look back, and I can see the beauty of that, but if I'm not careful, it'll snag me. In other words, I began to pray even, wanting the past to be present. I'm snagged in history. I'm snagged by the past. This is why the Apostle Paul said, I forget those things which are behind. Folks, this river's moving. Don't ever think God is not moving today. Never think that, because of the events, that it's just terrible. Don't be snagged by the past. The future is brighter and more brilliant than the past. Yes, I'm in the river. I can look behind and say, yeah, those were great days, but man, I'm going to stay in the love of God. I'm going to stay in the river and keep going with the direction that God is taking me. Now, I want you to take that vision and think about it in your own life. Think about floating in there. Now, something about the river, sometimes we want to get to the shore. Sometimes we get said, man, I'm seasick. This movement and this unknown and the changing of the scenery changes, the climate, hot, cold, all of that is changing, but his love never does. And the Bible says that there's nothing that can separate you from the love of God. Life, death, devils, future, angels, nothing can separate you from the love of God. But in his love, sometimes you want to get to the shore. And that's okay. The shore represents, I believe, somewhat of our security of what is known. An example would be when Jesus died and he rose from the dead, he had appeared to the disciples and says, Peter said, man, I'm going fishing. It wasn't that he was, what we may say, backsliding. He loved the Lord. He saw the Lord. He ate with the Lord after his death and resurrection. But it was so unknown. It was just so, what in the world's going to happen? I'm going to go back to what I know is safe and secure. I know fishing. I can make a living off fishing. That's the bank. That's the known. That's traditions. That's the same thing, traditions. And folks, there's nothing wrong with traditions. I think traditions are great. They're wonderful. But always remember, it's not the river. A while back, I asked the Lord, Lord, am I following you? Have you taken a turn? And what has happened to me is that I'm stuck in tradition. Am I just following the routine? Because I know how to do church. I know how to act. I know how to sing the song and behave myself. But is it just the tradition, or am I really following you? Ask that question. Are you on the bank and you're just watching the river? It's beautiful. I can look at the ocean and I love it. I love the waves. I go down there and I sit in the sand. But it's a great difference of just watching and then getting in. When I get in that ocean, everything changes. It's flat cold. And then the waves. And then, you know, you always think about sharks. And then just recently, Patty, she found this octopus rolled up onto the ocean. I mean, this thing's hideous looking. And that's in there. So unknown. So threatening. A lot of times, the love of God can threaten. It's so powerful. It's God. So a lot of times, I'd rather just sit on the beach and look at it, admire it, feel it, maybe get my ankles in it, you know, run out there and run back. But to really get in His love, I have to let go of control. I have to let go of the fact that, God, I'm not in control. You are. And I want to be in your control. I challenge you. Maybe you dabble in the love of God. Maybe you're up to your knees. Go on in. There's a letting go. There's something about letting go. The Lord talked to the church in Ephesus, said, you have great works. You're a wonderful church. You're faithful. You stand for truth. You're persecuted and yet you remain faithful, but I've got one thing that I hold against you, and you've left your first love. I think that is a picture of getting out of the river and sitting on the bank. Folks, there's something about His love. Is His love painful? Oh, you bet. You bet. I have tried to boogie board once or twice in my lifetime and was dumped, man. I mean, swallowing that water, coughing, getting up. I said, oh, never again, never again. The love of God is so magnificent, and there's so much involved in it. But I'll tell you this one thing, His love will never destroy you. It's really a savior. It's the movement of your life. And at times when you feel frustrated by just sitting on the bank and wanting to get off, you hear the voice of God, don't you? I hear His voice, and what He's saying is, come. Come on. Come to me. Peter was in the boat. He was safe. And he saw Jesus walking on that water, and he said, man, Lord, can I do that? And the Lord said, come. I believe He's saying that to all of us today. Come away with me. Come away with me. So wherever you're at in the river, snag, hit a rock, maybe on the bank, I want you to answer the call, come. Let's pray. Father, how you created this. How wonderful, how beautiful you are. You're so magnificent, Father, to create what I'm even looking at today. You're my creator. You're creating me. And I desire to answer that call to come. So I come, and I pray for everyone watching that, Lord, your spirit and the smell of that love and the drawing power of your love, that we'll leave our banks. We'll turn away from offense and look to you. We'll forget the past and we'll pursue you. And Father, maybe today some are in the rapids. Lord, this, I pray you give them strength. That Christ may dwell within their heart. The love of God may hold them through this season of rapids. No matter where we're at in life, Father, your love is so secure. Your love is that which makes life whole. And I thank you today, Father, as you pour your love out more and more and more. Well, folks, I'm tempted to take my clothes off and run into the ocean, but I don't think I will. God bless you, folks.